Before we get to the resolve property and routes, we need to talk about promises first. And Angular ships with a library called queue, which is a promise library. So if I just say queue defer, and I get a variable from that, and I say defer promise, on this promise and on the promise libraries you see around, there's a function called then, which will take a function, and when this when this object is done being deferred, meaning that when you call defer, when you call defer resolve, it's going to fire off this, and we'll just say I promised I would show up. So if I refresh, you can see it says I promised I would show up, because you're basically saying this is something that's going to happen in the future. This is when it happens in the future, and there you go. That's pretty much all promises. Something's going to happen in the future, so you set up a then to show what when successful, and we'll talk about error handling in other videos, but there's ways of doing that as well. So basically, once you have a promise set up, you can do a chain here, and we'll just add a couple more. So then, and we'll just say me too, and I. So you can see one, me too, and I. So these are things that are going to happen in the future, and as they keep on being, the promises keep on resolving, they move on to the next. So what you can do here is you can also pass in values. So if I said resolve sword, I could do an alert here, saying instead of I promised I would show up, let's say you can have my, and then we'll say plus weapon, and I need to add that as a parameter here. And then we'll return bow, say weapon here. Say and my plus weapon, and then we'll return X, and then another last weapon in here, and my weapon. So now if I do this, you see what's going to happen. It's going to say sword, pass in, you can have my sword, return bow, and the next promise, or the next then, you can have my axe. So you can have my sword and my bow and my axe. So you can pass along these results and then handle them in the following then functions. And that's basically all promises are. We'll get into more details about how you use them with the other libraries inside of Angular as we go along, but just basically know that you create a defer object that you will eventually call resolve on, and you can set up this promise, and in a lot of things what you do, you return that promise inside of Angular, and then it'll handle some of this then stuff for you. But if you're doing it manually like this, you can set up a chain of thens to fire as each one resolves. So that's pretty much it. This sets us up pretty well for diving into the resolve property and routing.